question of what happens after we die has intrigued humans for as long as we've been around.
As a physician, I know that most people don't think about death really until they're forced to.
Her brain was not functioning, and yet she had the most vivid experience.
My near-death experience changes how I understand death.
We think these people, they're gone, but they're always watching after us.
It is the age-old enigma of humankind. What happens after we die? Now a new Netflix series aims to answer man's greatest mystery by exploring life beyond our earthly experience. The show is called Surviving Death, and it's already conjuring up extraordinary conversations about life after death.
Joining us now via Skype, our director and executive producer, Ricki and the New York Times bestselling author of the book that inspired the series, Leslie Kane. Ladies, thank you for joining us today.
Hi.
Thank you for having us.
Yeah, thanks for having us.
Yeah, for sure. Let's talk about it. It's very fascinating, this show, because it's something, of course, we all know about. You guys discuss it there. You don't really want to think about it until you're sort of forced, right?
I guess I'll start. Yeah, I think it's a really intriguing topic. And Leslie, after reading Leslie's book, what I liked about it was that it was a serious look at a topic that sometimes can seem kind of woo-woo and seem kind of silly. And I think what the series does, it grounds it in real people's experience. So people who aren't necessarily thinking that much about afterlife or what might come next, who find themselves in these extraordinary situations.
All right, so this
And I think it asks a lot of questions too. I mean, we're not trying to prove that there is an afterlife or prove anything really. It's just opening the door to a lot of different possibilities and giving people things to contemplate and ask questions without really providing answers, but people will find their own answers.
All right, well, this series explores incredible stories of near-death experiences, which a lot of us have heard about. Mm-hmm. Your book includes one neurosurgeon and a terrible kayaking accident. Let's take a look at that.
I had been without oxygen for 30 minutes, and the statistical likelihood of my survival should have been zero. I did not want to go back down to my body. I had a very, very physical sensation of being held and comforted and reassured that everything was fine. But the beings told me that it wasn't my time, that I had more work to do on Earth, and that I had to go back to my body.
Ricki, I've seen this part of the show, and that was a pretty incredible story, and she goes on to be a doctor. But there are other people that you guys highlight as well, that, and they all have a common thread, these victims. Can we talk about that?
You mean the common experience of the phenomena?
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, what's interesting is that this doctor, she wasn't looking to have this experience, nor any of the other people in the series. And yet when they die and they're flatlined, they have, there are commonalities in their experience. They can be vastly different as well, but the study that's been done at the University of Virginia in the medical school at the Division of Perceptual Studies has logged these as similar kinds of experience. Sometimes there's light, sometimes there's a feeling of well-being, and sometimes there's not. So, I mean, there are these buckets that they tend to fall within, and Leslie probably can talk more about it.
Yeah, I mean, I think that's true. There are commonalities, and I think one of the important considerations of these experiences is how they change the people that have them, because once these people have what they consider to be a journey into the afterlife, that's what it feels like to them. They say it is more real and more vivid than anything they've ever experienced here on Earth, and it leaves them with a feeling of not being afraid of death. They feel that they have a sense of what's to come. It's nothing to be afraid of, and it completely can transform their lives because of that.
Yeah, now this show also delves into mediums, ghosts, reincarnation, and also science from the other side. So what's the biggest thing you want viewers to learn when they watch this?
Well, I think Leslie said it, which is that this is really just asking questions. I personally don't know what people are going to take away from it, but I think you ask more questions. If anything, people have said to me, are you convinced? And I said, I'm more convinced that I'm uncertain, that we don't really know necessarily everything, but that it's a fun, intellectually curious kind of program that raises lots of questions and makes you want to delve maybe more into it.
Leslie, you wrote the book Surviving Death. You've also been open about having an incredible experience in connecting with your brother who has passed.
Yeah, I mean, one of the things that happened while I was writing my book, which was very research-oriented, was that I suddenly lost my brother. And I didn't expect that to happen. And then I was studying after-death communications as part of the research for my book, and it seemed that I was having these experiences myself. So, you know, that was nothing I expected, but I did incorporate them into my book because I felt if I hadn't, it wouldn't have been honest and ethical of me because it shaped kind of my relationship to these experiences. So part of my book is a personal journey, and I do bring some of that, as you're showing now, into the series. So, yeah, a lot of very interesting things happened to me over the course of this whole journey that have been experiential as well as research-oriented.
So after all that work and research, what exactly do you believe, and what do you want your viewers to know?
I don't know who you're asking that to, but I mean, I'm very open to the possibility that consciousness does survive death in some form. And I can't prove that. And I'm not, you know, I don't know that absolutely for certain. But in my book, I do bring forward so much evidence from so many different areas that I think it really points to that being a very real possibility. So it brings me a lot of comfort and joy to be connected to that possibility. And I think the series also opens that door for people. We're not trying to prove anything, but it does show them that, hey, maybe this is a reality. Look what's happened to people. Yeah. And so it makes it possible for everyone.
Yeah, I'm not as convinced, but I'm, as I said, I'm more certain than I'm uncertain. And I think it's through the series, you ask questions and you continue to ask questions. And it's provocative.
All right. Well, Leslie and Ricki, thank you so much for joining us. I'm going to finish the show soon. I loved it. I started it. Yeah. So good to see you both, and good luck.
Thank you so much.
All right. Again, the show is called Surviving Death. You can stream the entire first season right now on Netflix, and you can order all of Leslie's bestsellers wherever books are sold.